The 2.0 EcoBoost engine was the pioneer of the new generation turbo engines for Ford cars, and it was first seen in 2008 and was massively implemented in dozens of models since 2010. You should know that in the 2016 and 2017 model years, Ford rebuilt the 2.0 EcoBoost engines, and since then the company has been using absolutely different twin-scroll turbo engines. But exactly the 2016, 2017 and 2018 model year cars could come with either older or newer type of engines. In this video, I'm covering the major problems with the older versions of the 2.0 EcoBoost. So the engine was initially based on the Mazda L engine series, which is an ancient and very reliable engine block. Ford did a lot of work and engineered a new engine, had a great fuel injection system, efficient TIVCT phasers, and of course a simple and reliable turbocharger. As a result, Ford got a 2-liter 4-cylinder engine that could compete with an average V6 in terms of power and torque, but offer perfect gas mileage. It's quite interesting that this engine had two different types of exhaust manifolds for Europe and North America. The American type has the exhaust integrated into the head, whereas the European one has separate exhaust ports with a traditional manifold. The European design proved to be much worse, as the manifold can crack and its pieces can easily kill the turbocharger, which is actually one of the common problems in Europe. This engine was used by Ford, Lincoln, Volvo, Range Rover and Jaguar cars all over the world, and there were literally millions of them made and sold. When it comes to problems, we should remember the software recall due to engine knocking. The knocking would cause vibrations and various unpleasant sounds under the hood, so if you ever get an early 2.0 EcoBoost in a used car, you should check if the updated software was installed under the recall. Also, this is a direct injection engine, and unless it's driven along highways, its intake valves will gradually get carbon buildup. It's a bad idea to use cheap spray cleaner, since you may easily damage the engine, which is quite expensive to repair. So owners have to pay heavy bills for professional intake valve cleaning from time to time. One more issue is that the TIVCT phasers prove to be faulty unless you use OEM Ford oil. Phaser replacement will cost you a fortune, so it's wise to stick to Ford Motorcraft oil and avoid experimenting with the recommended viscosity, which may be 5W20 or 5W30, depending on the country and engine model year. The engine has the timing chain, and I wouldn't say it's a problematic unit, but if you ever hear rattling, you should pay attention to the chain immediately. Chain jumping in this engine will most likely lead to an immediate engine death. Other than that, there are just some pretty uncommon issues with oil and coolant leaks, minor turbocharger problems, etc. On average, the first generation 2.0 EcoBoost engines could last about 200,000 miles without major problems, and after that milestone, everything depends on the quality of service and your luck. But overall, these were pretty good and reliable engines that basically ended the V6 era and became standard even in heavy and large vehicles.